scientists have finally uncovered the truth about the Titanic. On April 14, 1912, at 11:40 p.m., a terrible event occurred aboard the British liner Titanic that led to the ship's demise 3 hours later. At 2:20 a.m. on April 15, the largest ship of its time was swallowed up by the icy waters of the Atlantic Ocean. The Titanic sank to the bottom of the ocean, taking with it over 1,500 lives, two-thirds of the people on board. The reason for this terrible disaster, which led to so many deaths, was the collision with an iceberg, or at least that's what we were always told. But recent discoveries by scientists have debunked this theory. In this video, we will reveal the truth about the sinking of the Titanic, a truth that has remained hidden for more than a century. Being 268 meters long, 28 meters wide, and 53 meters high, with a lifting capacity of 46,328 tons, the Titanic seemed unsinkable. It would have taken several kilometers to walk around all the decks and corridors, and even the ship's officers needed more than 2 weeks to begin to navigate inside this huge structure. The Titanic had four massive chimneys, each weighing 60 tons and towering 25 meters, 12 centimeters, above the deck. Such an impressive height was required so that the 100 tons of soot blown from the chimneys daily would not settle on the ship and its passengers. The pipes were installed at an angle of 30 degrees to make them look even more spectacular and majestic. No less impressive was the price of the liner, which cost $7.5 million to build. If you consider today's exchange rates and inflation, then in 2023, such a project would have cost $196 million. Even the shooting of the world-famous movie Titanic in 1997 would have cost even more, $235 million. The Harland and Wolff shipyard hired 3,000 people to build the ship. Even with a huge number of workers toiling 6 days a week from 6 in the morning, the task was so enormous that the Titanic wasn't launched until 26 months later. It was a difficult and dangerous construction. Imagine doing something at the height of a 20-story building without safety ropes. But people needed money to feed their families, and workers were getting £2 a week, which doesn't sound very tempting, but it was quite a decent wage at the time. During the construction of the Titanic, 8 people died in the shipyard and 246 were injured. Given all the effort and money invested in the creation of this giant machine, it is hard to believe that it was the victim of a simple iceberg. And now new discoveries suggest that the real cause of the disaster was not ice, but fire. Journalist Shannon Maloney has been investigating the Titanic wreck for over 30 years. He discovered a huge 9-meter black spot on the hull of the ship. He noticed it while studying a photograph taken before the ship sailed. The thing is that Maloney managed to find a scrapbook of previously unknown photographs that were taken during the construction and preparation of the liner for its first and only flight. Judging by the footprints, the fire had been going on for 3 weeks in very high temperatures before someone noticed and put it out. Experts from the steel industry believe that such exposure could have easily weakened the metal, reducing its strength by as much as 75%. That's why the iceberg had no trouble ripping through the hull of the ship. If it hadn't been for the fire, this would never have happened. But the fact that the iceberg hit exactly where the metal was weakened was just one link in a chain of amazing and tragic events that led to the Titanic's demise. The leaders of the ship knew of the fire and that the ship should not set out on that fateful voyage, but the delay in sailing meant bankruptcy for the ship owners. Just at that moment, all over the country, the miners were on strike, and to keep the furnace of the Titanic running, there was little coal left. However, the tickets were already sold out and the rest of the flights had been canceled because everyone wanted to be the first to voyage on the largest ship in history. So the Titanic's owners bought up all the coal they could find and even coal from other ships. Cancellation of the voyage was not possible. To hide the truth, the ship was turned so that the burn side was turned toward the ocean, so that the passengers on the dock could not see the traces of the fire. And so the voyage began. The prototype for the interior of the Titanic was the interior of the Ritz Hotel in London. The front staircase went down through 7 of the ship's 10 decks. It was decorated with paintings, bronze figures, cherubim, and oak panels. The amenities for first-class passengers included a heated swimming pool, Turkish baths, a gym, a squash court, and a beauty salon. They could even call in a hairdresser to help them get their hair done for dinner. There was a newspaper on board the liner, the Daily Atlantic Bulletin. The Titanic also had a special place for the dogs of first-class passengers. They were fed, taken for walks, and could even be trained during the voyage. Dinner for first class, a lavish ceremony that lasted about 5 hours, consisted of 13 courses each, of which a special wine was served. There were 1,500 bottles of wine, 20 million bottles of beer, and 8,000 cigars. However, there wasn't a single pair of binoculars. This is noteworthy because having binoculars could have saved the Titanic. This is another tragic coincidence in the chain of fateful events. Back then, there were no sonars, so in order to detect threats along the ship's path, special people were watching the horizon with binoculars, but on the Titanic, all the binoculars remained locked away in a special cabinet. The only person with a key to the locker, Second Assistant David Blair, was replaced at the last minute. He was in such a hurry to leave the ship that he forgot to give the key to his second-in-command. This oversight was not discovered until 3 days later, when the liner was already in the ocean. Had the crew had access to binoculars, the iceberg would have been spotted much earlier, and the collision would have been avoided. And the tragedy might not have happened if the ship hadn't been traveling at an excessive speed. The Titanic was out of schedule and it was unacceptable to its reputation, which is why it was going at a speed much higher than what its gears were designed for. Another factor contributing to the tragedy was criminal negligence regarding the lifeboats. In order to accommodate all the people on board, the Titanic required about 60 lifeboats. However, the chief designer, Alexander Carlyle, decided to equip the ship with only 48 boats. Over time, that number was reduced even further to 20, for aesthetic reasons, as 48 boats made the deck look too cluttered. The remaining 20 boats could only accommodate a third of all the passengers aboard. It's hard to believe, but such monstrous lack of lifeboats was not considered a violation according to the laws of the time. The number of lifeboats required depended not on the number of passengers, but on the tonnage of the ship. At the dawn of the 20th century, lifeboat loading exercises were a common practice on ocean liners. The crew used these exercises to prepare passengers for possible emergencies. However, such activities were never conducted on the Titanic. Captain Edward John Smith canceled a drill scheduled for the morning of the day the ship collided with an iceberg. The reason for this decision remains unclear, especially considering that other ships had warned the Titanic about the presence of ice in the area. It took the crew more than half an hour to launch the lifeboats into the water, instead of the standard 10 minutes. Some have blamed Captain Smith for this delay. At first, the lifeboats left the ship half empty and the first one only seated 27 passengers, even though it was designed to carry 65 people. People were slow to evacuate and didn't realize that they were in real danger. In 2012, researchers revealed that Captain Smith had failed his first navigation exam, but later passed it. Some speculate that this could have played a role in the tragedy. The Titanic crew managed to send several signals for help, but the nearby ship Californian ignored the flares. The captain of the Californian was later fired when this became known to the public. However, recent findings by historians have proven his innocence. It's possible that no one saw the Titanic signals because of the phenomenon of refraction. layers of cold air beneath layers of warmer air can cause an abnormal refraction of light, which creates mirages. This has been recorded by several other vessels that have sailed in those latitudes. Historian Tim Maltin is also convinced that the refraction of light prevented the lookout from spotting the iceberg that night. Whether it was criminal negligence, a tragic chain of coincidences, fire, or ice, the sinking of the Titanic took the lives of hundreds and continues to haunt researchers and the public. What theory do you believe in? Share in the comments. The tragedy of the Titanic remains one of the biggest mysteries in history. Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more amazing videos. Stay tuned.